Hi, this is Matt with Custom Car Grills. This 2010 through 13 Toyota Tundra install starts by applying a half-inch tape guide. When applied correctly, the tape will give us a consistent cutting depth to work with. The tape for this should be exactly a half-inch wide, and we do have it available on our website if needed. Placement of the tape is very important here. I'm not placing it on the top edge or on the beveled edge as shown here. Proper placement is directly below the beveled edge on the inner lip. I'm going to double check the tape and then grab my handsaw to start cutting out the bulk of the intersection. I'm making short work of the vertical bars by sawing through them near where they meet the edge. The left and right sides should also be cut near the edge, but due to the awkward angle of the cut, it's okay to leave a little extra material. It's best to be patient and accurate for this step. If done correctly, the center portion should lift out with ease. Next, I'll be ready to go with my Dremel. Attached to it is the number 543 cutting and shaping wheel. I'm just simply cutting near the tape line, maybe a 32nd of an inch under to give me a little room for error. It's very important to keep a steady hand when doing these cuts so I don't lose control of the Dremel. Along the way, it's okay to do some of this in sections to make it a little bit more manageable. Connecting plastic pieces on the back will also need to be cut. Next, I'm going to trim the plastic on the side edge about as close to the tape as I can get, and then remove any large plastic bits. Now it's time to swap from cutting to shaping using the same number 543 Dremel bit. The top of the cutting wheel is very abrasive, and by lightly pressing that to the edge of the grill, I can shave the plastic a little bit at a time. This technique can be used with the grill facing up, but sometimes it's easier with the grill facing down. For anyone not familiar with using a Dremel this way, the large center plastic section that was removed earlier can be used for practice. The tape guide can be removed and discarded once the plastic is trimmed to the tape edge. Then I'm going to make sure the edges look good before moving on to shaving some of the burnt bits with a knife. Next, I'll be trimming back some of the plastic near the screw clips, as well as the couple large tabs near the top center of the grill, and the couple large tabs on each side. To do the final smoothing from the cutting, I'll be using some various sandpapers. Typically, I'll start with a 100 grit sandpaper, and then work down to a 300 or 400 to get a smooth edge. It's important to be careful and not slip during this step, and scuff the edge that will be seen. Now let's take a look at the mesh that we have for sale on our website. It's pre-cut specifically for the 2010 through 13 Tundra and can be ordered plain, but it can also be accessorized with a small retro Toyota emblem such as this one, or a TRD badge put in the lower corner. For this specific install, we're going to use the laser cut 4-inch letters in gloss black. These mesh pieces are shipped flat and the corners will need to be slightly bent before installation. If the bend is done properly, the mesh piece should rest on the back of the grill easily, otherwise additional bending may be needed. With the mesh in place, I'm now going to use some foam and cable ties to temporarily secure the mesh to the grill. The foam will help protect the factory paint job while the ties are pulled tight. As for the ties, I like having the tie head on the back of the mesh like so, and then tightly fastening the tie and then trim the ends. With stubborn ties that aren't pulling the mesh close enough to the grill, I sometimes use pliers or vice grips. To bond the mesh to the grill, I like using an adhesive called automotive goop. This adhesive works well bonding mixed materials for projects such as this one. For easily accessible areas, it can be used right out of the tube. But for tighter areas, I like using a small object like a toothpick to apply the goop more accurately. I used two full 3.7 ounce bottles for this installation, and it's important to note that I also made sure none dripped through the front. After the adhesive is cured, the ties and foam can be removed, and then I'm going to remove the metal hood latch bracket that was on the old center grill section. We're including a new bracket that will fasten to the old one and the grill frame. The screw clips can be adjusted up or down slightly if needed. A little dab of adhesive on the screws will also keep them in place long term. When looking at the grill face down, the screw left of center is the one to use for fastening our bracket in place. Applying adhesive to the bracket where it comes in contact with the grill will help its stability. Now let's turn over the grill and check out our mesh installation to see how it turned out. Wow, this looks really good. Overall, this wasn't too difficult to install. The most important part is keeping the attention to detail with the cutting portion, and making sure to apply enough adhesive in all the right spots. I hope you liked this video. Feel free to contact me with any questions about it.